inside the app that lets Uber drivers scout for investor deals in real estate. What do you like about this?
Oh my God, I love all of it. I think it's fabulous. I think it's brilliant. I'm a little sad that I feel like I've been in like mom world too long to not come up with it on my own.
I haven't even seen it until we saw this Inman article, which of course we're going to post all the articles on YouTube.
So it's not just for Uber drivers, but they're obviously finding that Uber drivers are really the ones that seem to be the most successful in it, because investors go to this, what's it called, Deal Machine?
Yeah, the app is called Deal Machine. It launched in 2017 and it operates on this novel premise. It's not good. All right. Hire people who are already out driving around to scout properties for real estate investors, like the people they mentioned in this article.
Yeah.
When drivers notice properties that might make good investments, they simply take a picture and pin the location in Deal Machine's app.
I love it. So it sounds like the what I haven't gone onto the app or the website. I should. I'm actually really excited to hop on when we get off here. But it sounds like the deals start, like, if you're an investor, you pay like $50 a month. I don't know what you get for the $50
a month. Monthly fee of $49.
And people literally drive around, and when they find a property that fits it, they pin it, and then the app actually gets the contact information, the homeowner's name. I don't know if it gets phone numbers, but it does sound like it does a pretty deep dive into who owns the property. It sounds like there is the capability, though, that if there is a driver that you become like accustomed to, or that you feel like you trust, you could just like hire them directly too. So like you pay them like a per hourly rate, and which is great, because I feel like with investors, like there's certain things that certain investors are looking for. So I would personally want to hire someone that knew like my criteria, so that obviously their time was being well spent instead of me going through pins all day of garbage. But super interesting. I feel like it could totally go beyond just investors in this situation.
And like some of the best deals are found when you're just, maybe you're working on a property over here and you're like, hey, that one looks like nobody's been living there for 3 years.
Well, what's super, I mean, I feel like that's like the golden rule of real estate. Like you're never supposed to take the same route twice, because like you're supposed to, oh, you didn't know that?
The golden rule?
I feel like
I thought it was location, location, location.
No, I feel like when I feel like that's
investor
sort of like,
rule.
Yeah, like you, like if you're going, if you go to a, if you go, have an appointment, whether it's work related or personally related, you're always supposed to go a different way.
Learn the area
back, so that you know you could. You're passing, so you're not always going your same road. So you do find opportunities. Yes.
Yep.
Okay. Well,
I like that.
Yeah.
Well,
anyway,
Uber drivers must have a lot of downtime, unless you're in like New York City or one of these big cities, then obviously you're going to just be running from pickup to pickup to pickup. But where we are here on the little Connecticut shoreline, for example, they've got to have a lot of downtime. I just took an Uber back from JFK, New York City, all the way to Madison, Connecticut.
Where were they coming from? Were they coming from Connecticut or were they coming from New York? Like
they were in New York.
And they drove you to Connecticut.
And then he you know, he selected
he
my route.
Was he like, yay?
He got into the, well, when I got into the car, he goes, hey, so you're pretty far, huh? I said, you accepted the job, man. I don't know what to tell you. But like, I was thinking about it when he dropped me off. I gave him a nice cash tip and a five-star review, if anyone's wondering. But I'm like, man, he literally at that point, because it was during the middle of the day, so you're going to have traffic, he had a two-hour drive back.
Right.
Like if he was going back
to JFK
area.
Well, what he should do is pick up jobs along the way back.
Right, and I'm thinking about this now for him. He could have been just deal machining it the whole way back.
Well, that's your day.
You know?
That's your day. This dropping you off was
and then deal machining. But then you're getting off 95. I don't know. But yeah, you're waiting around different. I mean, I've taken.
Could you imagine though? Now
your
trip takes a little bit longer because the guy's now
like,
driving around to take pictures of homes.
I've got a deal over here. I just take a photo.
I just have to take a photo real quick.
I want a referral
fee.
I love it.
I mean, in all honesty, I feel like there's some people in this. Not some people, but I feel like most drivers that I run into, whether they're an Uber driver or a limo driver, you know, that you're calling like an actual driving. 99.9% of these people actually really legitimately love driving. They just love driving around. I know that when I was like 16, 17, like I loved just like driving around, wasting gas, where maybe they don't want to have to deal with people anymore. It's like you know, this is the best way to keep driving around, but then not having to deal with like the people getting into your car. I mean, there's, you know, it's like small, it's like a hairdresser. Like I can never be a hairdresser. Like there's just so much chit chat. Like
lots of chit chat.
I mean,
they're the best referrals. If you're an agent out there, hairdressers, best referral source. They talk to everybody. It's like having a therapist. And hairdressers don't mind telling everybody what, you know, the people in their chair said to them.
Yes, I just couldn't imagine doing that.
And here's this. If you read the article, there's another company, Be Polite Properties, and they're basically leaning into Deal Machine's platform. Their drivers get $1 to $2 per approved lead, depending on what part of the country they're working for. And then if the company ultimately closes on one of those properties, the driver also gets a commission.
Wow!
So you're getting,
can you do that?
Yeah, I mean, somebody got $700.
Oh, because these are investors, so they're not even real estate. So there's nothing real estate.
There's no rules.
Right. Okay.
It's not like NAR's going to come slap you on the wrist.
I love it. If you guys have heard of it or have done it, or if you're driving around pinning houses, I'd love to know about it. I feel like I want to start pinning houses.
Yeah, they're sending some big,
I'm thinking again, even if
here.
You're even if it's not for investors, like you could just have someone drive and just get leads. Like hey I see a dumpster. Like,
I saw an article on Inman this week. If you're sick of real estate, here's a few things to do. This might be one of the things. Right? They should put this in the article.
They should.